it's Ariana here with another YouTube video for you guys. And for this video, I'm telling you guys about my experience at Fame Expo. If you guys are unaware of what Fame Expo is, it's basically a beauty convention. So think about BeautyCon and any other beauty conventions that you guys may know of. Fame Expo, though, it's completely different because they're not like, they're not together, basically, you know? Today, though, I was really surprised with the brands that were there and present. So I went to BeautyCon last year for the first time ever during the summer, and it was amazing. I had such an amazing time. If you guys want to know more about that, you guys can go ahead and watch my YouTube videos a couple months back. But now, Fame Expo, honestly, I was expecting more, not gonna lie. I thought there would be more people. I felt like the vibe wasn't lit, you know? I did buy a lot, but the products, like many of the products that were being given away weren't as good, or there was just, you know, brands that were giving away samples, if that. So yeah, I mean, it was okay. I wouldn't buy tickets to the event. I am gonna say I won these tickets, so it's not like, you know, I bought them and like felt dissatisfied. I want these tickets to Fame Expo the day before it started. Crazy. So yeah, so for this video, I am gonna go over the things that I bought. There was a couple things that I got for free, like 2 or 3 brushes, and I think that was it. But yeah, there were really good brands. But the point is, I wasn't really feeling it, to be honest. But I did buy a lot of good stuff, so let's get to it. Alright, so first off is Sigma Beauty. They were giving away this amazing, I'd say like shopping bag. Like, I think this is the type that you would get when you buy from their shop or whatever. Like I said, there wasn't a lot of stuff that was being given away. And me and my friend, we went Saturday and Sunday, and we were there from start to finish. And oh, another thing, there wasn't like, I know the space was small compared to BeautyCon, but me and my friend, we literally walked around the whole thing like 50 times and we were bored. You know, there wasn't enough. Like, at some booths, like, we would have to wait in line and stuff. Like, for example, Morphe, girl, that line was hectic. And ABH, you know, the like known brands. But other than that, it was pretty lame. Like, I feel bad saying this, you know, because although I did have fun, because it was like a new experience, it wasn't like what I expect, basically. So okay, let's get started here. And I got this liquid brush cleanser. They have a lot of stuff that you may use to clean your brushes. I've never tried the brand, I'm gonna be honest, so I'm not sure how good their products may be. So I, you know, don't take my word for it. But basically, they had like a whole section of like brands. So one of the stuff that I got was the Makeup Forever foundation. It was, so typically I use a Fit Me by Maybelline, but it was, so everything that I bought was like a discounted price. So say like at the store or online, it'll be like 36, in person it was like 22 or $20. It would depend on the brand and what the actual product was, but it was really, really affordable. So I bought the Makeup Forever Ultra HD foundation. Next off is a liquid lipstick by ABH in the shade Catherine. So I'm not gonna shade, swatch anything, just because I have a lot to show and I can like talk about these products forever. And then I also bought the Laura Mercier translucent powder. I had heard really great things about this powder. I did not have it prior to this, obviously, And I already used it. I already tried it multiple times and I loved it. I believe the typical like retail price is around 36. And me and my friend, we got it for $22. So that's a pretty good deal. So then from ABH, I got the dark brown dip brow pomade. It was $12. I bought mine for, I believe, $18 or $20-something. Like I said, you guys, the deals were amazing. So that is all for that was in this bag. So I had no idea about this brand. I did not know it existed. And as soon as we went to like their booth, I swatched everything and I fell in love. And it was really, really, really affordable. So it's Beauty Creations. And their booth was actually pretty packed, but honestly, like, I don't blame them. Their stuff is really, really good. So I bought the Cali Collections Beauty Creations palette. So it includes two palettes and one highlighting palette. So I'm about to show that to you guys. And I also bought a, it's called the Sweetest palette. So when I swatched it, I'm about to open it for you guys so you guys can kind of get the idea of what it looks like. I felt like it was a kind of like a dupe for the Sweet Peach palette. And it actually has like a scent to it as well. So I thought, you know, that's pretty like ironic. So yeah. So these are the two palettes that are in the collection that I've just shown you guys. So this one is Cali Set and this one is Cali Cheek, or Chick, I should say. So let's open it up. And the shades are amazing, you guys. Take a look for yourself. I know it's kind of far away. So this is the other palette. This one, I'm not gonna lie, gave me like the vibes of Renaissance palette from ABH. So at first I was kind of like sketchy about buying it, but you know, I was like, eh, whatever. So take a look. I'm gonna insert images as well. To keep on going on as to what's in this collection, we have the Cali Glow, which includes three shades that I'm about to show you guys and I think are really, really good. So first off, I'm gonna say the Manhattan Beach came broken. So I bought this on Saturday and when I got home, I texted my friend freaking out and she was like, just take it on Sunday, you know, tomorrow, and I'm sure they're gonna change it. But I was like, no, you know what, I don't want to deal with it. So I went ahead, I went to YouTube, you know, YouTube is a girl best friend, and I searched how to like fix it basically, and I think I got it. You know, it looks pretty, you know, usable. I'm not gonna say perfect, but I think we can go with it. Okay, so this next is pretty random. This is not, it's not related at all to the bag. I just put in like all the single products in here just so I can like keep it to a minimum. So here we go. So I bought these eyelashes. These are some Fox Mink lashes. I forgot which brand these are from, but this is what they look like. Then we have, so I got this for free, I won it. Usually they have like trivias in each booth, or at least some do. And I won this angled perfect brush. I'm really, really excited to use. I'm sure you guys can see it from there. Okay. And then we have have another angled brush. It's the same. Oh, and also the products from here, I forgot, are from Morphe. So on Sunday, Morphe was my first stop. I spent like $70. My bank account right now is crying, okay? Okay, so what else I got here? So this is a concealer brush. This, I also want this. I think I'm really gonna like this. This is a sample from, I don't know what brand, and I don't know what it is, but it's a sample. Okay, so this is a powder, the Laura Mercier powder, translucent powder. And, okay, and these lashes that I want, they're from Simply Glam. They look alright, they look alright. Okay. So, what else we got in here? So this is my wristband that they give us for Fame Expo. Ugh, my bandages get stuck to it, so you guys can see it says Fame on there. Okay, so going on to the Morphe products, I bought, so this is a lot actually, this is a lot. So starting off with this Morphe E60 fan brush, I like to use it for the highlight, so I'm really excited about that. Okay, let's move this here. So I bought this Morphe liquid lip, really pretty. The guy swatched it for me on his hand and I was shook. Like seriously, I wasn't expecting it to be that pretty. Oh my God, you guys, I bought so many brushes. Okay. So first on is a E11. It's an angled concealer brush. Sorry if you guys like can't see it. I know the background sucks. Next one is Morphe M574. It's like a blending brush that you guys can use. I should say like what it was for, but when I bought it, each brush was on this like casket or basket, and it was like labeled as to what the purpose was. So this is another brush. Okay. this is an angled brush. I really like these because I use them for it's actually a spoolie. Like it includes spoolie for the eyebrows, but I really like this side because I can use it for the concealer and like for the brows, you know, cleaning out your brows. This is another concealer brush, but it's just different. It's like more pointy. I'm not sure if you guys can capture that from that distance. And these next two are really tiny. So I'm gonna try and show them. They're similar, they're identical. They're the same type, but you know, I'm gonna show it like this maybe. Okay. And next we have another liquid lipstick. This is in the shade Macchiato. So you actually, wait, this is a concealer, my bad. This is a concealer. The guy, he was like, oh, they're gonna remove them from the brand. Cause you guys know, like, some products don't last forever. And so that was like one of them. And it was actually just $2. Everything here was less than $6 except the palette. The palettes I'm about to show you guys. And so I was just like, you know what, might as well buy them, you know, I can never have enough concealers. So this is a lip liner. It's in the shade Foolish. So, and this is the shade. Yeah. another liquid lip on the shade Jealousy. Okay. You guys can see it's kind of like a pinkish tone, you know. Pinkish slash brownish. It's not too pink, it's not too brown. And with the purchase of any product in Morphe, you would get a free gel eyeliner. So that's pretty dope, Okay guys, so now to finish off this haul from Fame Expo, I'm gonna be showing you guys the two palettes that I bought from Morphe. So the first one is Happy Hour, which is in this box. It includes 15 shades. And these are the shades that it includes. So I'm trying to blind you guys here. Okay. I hope you guys can see that. I'm really sorry if you can't, by the way. Like I said, the way I show things isn't the greatest. So I really like all of them. I really like that it has a lot of shimmery shades. So I think that's why, that's the main reason I got it. And honestly, you can never have enough. I really, really like the variety. I feel like you can make several types of looks with these. I feel like it's not too restricted, you know? And this is Brunch Babe. It also includes 15 shades to mix it up. So again, I really like all of them. If I'm being honest, I really like Squad. So take a look at what it looks like. You know? So yeah, I think Squad is really, really good. I have not swatched any of them, so I'm not really sure how they may look on me. Sometimes the colors are not as pigmented on my skin, so it's kind of hard for me to find a good palette for me to use. But yeah, I've gone through everything that I bought at Fame Expo. I spent a lot. I did have a lot of fun, but I am hoping I can attend BeautyCon next month in July. And and we'll see. If I do, of course I'll be showing, I'll be filming a video for YouTube for you guys to watch. And thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys stayed from beginning to end, I appreciate that so much. I really, really do. I really like YouTube. And although, I may look different and I may do things a bit differently, I really do enjoy doing it. And although I may not have as many subscribers as others or many views as others, I just do it for the sake of my happiness. Basically. So again, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like it, make sure to subscribe, leave a like, or leave a comment and like the video. I'm always terrible at ending my videos. I don't know why. But anyways, I'll stop rambling. Okay, I'm gone now. Bye guys.